Hello students, today we will have a session in cost accounting for the students of TY BCom semester 6. In cost accounting, we will be dealing with the topic process costing. The flow of our discussion will be like this. First, we will have introduction of process costing, then meaning of process, then features of process costing, some important terms in process costing, how process account is prepared, how cost per process is determined, what are the benefits of process costing, and what are the limitations of process costing. Basically, what is meant by process costing and where it is applicable? Process costing is a method of costing. In costing, we have two categories: method of costing and techniques of costing. Process costing is a method of costing used for ascertaining cost in manufacturing industries. What is manufacturing industry? Manufacturing industry is one in which raw material is converted into finished product. While converting it into finished product, entire process is subdivided into small processes. And each of this process is accountable in process costing. This method is used for allocation of total cost to each process involved in manufacturing. As I told you, the total cost of the product is broken as per cost at each process. Now, process, that is manufacturing concern, how process flows. First of all, a raw material is introduced in process 1 and processing starts. After we get semi-processed goods from process 1, that is output of process 1 is transferred to process 2, and in process 2 it becomes input. Again some processing takes place and output of process 2, which is once again work in progress or semi-finished product, is transferred to process 3. Here we have 3 processes. This can be 4, 5, 6, as many as are required for converting raw material into finished product. We have taken 3 and process 3 is our final process. The output of process 3 shall be finished product, right? Which is available for sale. Features of process costing. Separate account is prepared for each process. For every process, we prepare separate process account. The output of one process becomes input of next process. Just like just now we have discussed, output of process 1 becomes input of process 2. Output of process 2 becomes input of process 3. Like this. Loss at each process is properly accounted for. As we prepare separate account for every process, at every process, whatever loss we are incurring, that is properly accounted. Excess cost incurred, if any, is easily accounted for. That is, if we feel or if we realize that cost of our product is higher than other firms in the industry, where we are incurring heavy cost, in which process there are loopholes, can be easily identified if we have process costing in our concern. These are some of the important terms in process costing. First one is input. What is input? Input means number of units we are introducing in process. Output. Output means number of units coming out of the process as finished product. Finished product of that process. Every process has input and output. Normal loss. Normal loss means loss within expected level. That is loss which occurs as a normal condition. Normal process. Where though there is no irregularity, this loss is bound to happen. It never happens that the number of units we are introducing in the process and the number of units we are getting as output are same. Some units are bound to get loss. That is normal loss. Then what is abnormal loss? Abnormal loss is loss over and above expected level. That is, when above normal loss we incur more loss, that becomes our abnormal loss. And what is abnormal gain? Sometimes it may happen that loss which is normal and we are expecting that it will occur, doesn't occur. And we get more good units. That becomes our abnormal gain. Let us have detailed explanation of these terms, especially normal loss, abnormal loss and abnormal gain. Normal loss, as I told you, it is loss within expected level. Supposing we will take one example. In process, we are introducing 5000 kg. Normal loss as per industry rate is 10%. So we are expected to lose 500 kg, 10% of 5000. And our expected output is 4500 kg. This is normal situation. If it is happening, we are on right path. But actually when we see what has happened after completing process, we had introduced 5000 kg and our loss is 20%. Normal industry loss is expected as 10%, but we have incurred 20% loss. And 20% of 5000, it is 1000 kg. And therefore, our actual output is 4000 kg. Remember, we were expecting 4500 kg. And our output is 4000 kg. It means, normal loss 500 kg we have incurred. And over and above that, 500 kg abnormal loss we have incurred. Abnormal gain, output beyond expected level, whatever level of output we were expecting, more than that we are getting. Continuing with the same example, we have introduced 5000 kg. Now here we were expecting 10% loss, but we have incurred only 5% loss due to some better technology or higher efficiency. We did not have even normal loss and we have incurred only 5%, that is 250 kg, and our actual output is 4750 kg. Here, out of normal loss of 500 kg, we have not incurred 250 kg and therefore our output is 4750. Expected output was 4500. So 250 is our abnormal gain. This is format of process account. On the debit side, we have all expenses. Material, that is material introduced in that particular process. Wages paid to workers working for that process. Direct expenses which are directly attributable to that process. Production overheads which are directly connected to that process. These are all expenses incurred in the process. On the credit side, we have normal loss. Just now we have seen. Normal loss are bad output. But organization always tries to sell it at cheaper rate, which is scrap value. Then, whatever output firm is getting from the process, generally firm transfers it to next process. But in some cases, firm has a choice. And what they do is, part of the output they transfer to next process and part of the output they transfer to, they sell it in market. Let us take one example. Supposing we have dairy products. And from milk, for organization is preparing curd as well as buttermilk. In process 1, milk is kept to make curd. After getting curd, what firm is doing? Part of the curd it is selling in the market as curd itself, and part of the curd it is transferring to next process for making buttermilk. Now here this is buttermilk output transfer to next process, and this is curd which is directly sold. This may or may not happen. On the debit side, we also have abnormal gain. The meaning of abnormal gain we have seen just now. And credit side, we have abnormal loss. Remember, normal and abnormal loss both are credited to process account. And this is format, so I am showing both of them. But in none of process account, you will find both abnormal gain and abnormal loss. If firm is incurring abnormal loss, you won't have abnormal gain. If firm is incurring abnormal gain, you won't have abnormal loss. After completing this process account, if we find debit side is less heavier than credit, it is credit is more than debit, it means we are getting profit. It means we are getting profit, which is transferred to costing P&L account. If debit is more than credit, it means we are incurring loss, which is again transferred to costing P&L account. In both the case, again, in one single process account, you will not find both profit and loss. These are expenses debited to process account. Now, after preparing process account, the cost of each process is computed. How it is computed? It is computed using one formula. The formula is total debit of process account, that is this total, minus normal loss amount, this amount, divided by total debit units introduced, input units. It is this minus normal loss in units. Once we do this calculation, what we get is cost of process, or it is also called as rate of process. Now, benefits of process costing. Periodic determination of cost. As every process, at every process we are computing cost, it becomes easier, so it is simple and easy. Periodically, because it is simple and easy, we can do it frequently. Better managerial control, because we come to know the loophole where it is going wrong and we can immediately correct it. Easy for making decision. If any particular process is incurring heavy cost, then whatever corrective actions are required, immediately decisions can be taken. What are the limitations? Difficulty in getting overall picture, because every process we determine cost. So what is overall picture of the organization? We have to compile all the process history. That becomes little difficult. It is based on historical cost. It always tells us what has happened. It doesn't give us future picture. And the concept of normal loss and abnormal loss may not be accurate. It may change from time to time, place to place, and incidence to incidence, firm to firm. So this may not be exact. These are all limitations. Students, I hope this discussion will help you for preparing for your examination and solving more and more practical problems in cost accounting. Wish you all the best. Thank you.